Hey, everybody. My name is Nina Taylor. Welcome to my show, my TV show, Behind the Mic. Today, my special guest is an actor. He's a personal trainer, a bodybuilder, a nutritionist. He does so much. He's very, very awesomely talented. And I'm so happy to have him on the show. Once again, his name is Elsie. How you doing, honey?
I'm doing well. How you doing? Long time no see.
Yeah. You haven't been on the show since what, 2019? What's the last one?
Yeah, I think it's about that long.
Yeah, we haven't spoken since COVID.
Yeah. A lot of things been happening since COVID.
Absolutely. You've been busy too. Oh, of course, before COVID. Let's first start off. I mentioned that you were an actor and you've been in so many great movies, Black Panther, Burden, which has become, I've watched Burden at least 5 times, okay?
I watched it 3 times. So
yeah, it's a very good film. I love it. Of course, I've watched Black Panther 20, 30, who knows? I quit most recently Coming to America. First, why don't you tell everybody how you got started in acting, first of all?
Well, I got started a long time ago. I auditioned for a McDonald's commercial. A friend of mine, him and I wound up going in the wrong building.
It was by accident,
but nothing's by accident. That's the way I think. Definitely sparked the interest. We went into the wrong building and they said, oh, you here to audition for the McDonald's commercial? We looked at each other like, McDonald's commercial? I like McDonald's. At that time, I liked McDonald's. So I was kind of confident I was going to get it, you know what I mean? And he was confident too. So we both went in there. And it's crazy, they auditioned us both at the same time. You know, I thought I found out later on, individually to interview you. So anyway, we both went in there. We sat down. They said, okay, read this. Now say it. So I said in my lines, I forgot what it was. It was something about McDonald's. It was like 2 seconds. And he said it. I said it. We both said it at the same time. And they said, okay, thank you. But they never called us back. So we said, oh, okay. So we just laughed it off and went on to the next destination we were supposed to be going to. But it all started when I was in Florida, living in Florida for like 20-something years. I started getting into fitness, and I took it really seriously because I seen a lot of dudes out there and people out there were really fit. But I thought, since it's Florida, people will be in better shape.
Yeah.
But little did I know, I guess, you know, whatever. So I got in shape, got in pretty decent shape, and I met this friend of mine. She said, hey, you need to audition for this calendar, Black Male Calendar, this guy looking for models.
Okay.
So I said, okay, let me try that. So I tried it, got it. I was in a calendar called the Black Real Men Calendar. Mm-hmm. I think it was 1990 Real Men Calendar in Orlando, Florida. And I was February. And later on, I had someone else ask me to do some more calendars later on in the future. But then one day somebody seen my calendar and they said, hey, what you need to audition for Mortal Kombat, the TV show.
Oh.
And I said, wow, Mortal Kombat, the TV show. Okay. So I auditioned for the TV show Mortal Kombat. I didn't get the part what I was looking for, but I was in it. And I was in it for like a couple seasons. And I think I was in there for 2 seasons and about 20 episodes. You know, so I was out there for a while.
Yeah.
It was good. And then it started.
Was that filmed in Florida as well?
I didn't hear you. Say it again.
Was that filmed in Florida, Mortal Kombat?
Yes, it was shot in Florida. It was shot in Disney background. And I never knew Disney had so much land. Of course, they have so much land. But we had to be up at 5:00 in the morning, but I had to be up there early because I didn't have a car at that time. So I had to catch a bus. So I had to get up early and get up there early. And we got there on set. It was hot. It was hot early in the morning. So hot. I couldn't believe how hot it was early in the morning. And we were out there in the swamps. But it was worth it. It was worth it. It was a lot of fun. It was interesting meeting great people, work with some people. Now I see them on bigger, better things, like the lady from who played this female Terminator.
Oh, yeah.
I met her, and I didn't know that was her. And then it was crazy when I seen that. And then I realized people say, oh, that's a chick from Mortal Kombat.
Okay.
Hold on 1 second.
Hold on. Okay.
Oh, I'm sorry. So anyway,
yeah,
and I was friends with her, and I was cool with her. We were cool with each other. We started getting personal, you know, because we seen each other every day on the set.
Yeah.
And a couple of them asked me to train them, but I couldn't do it because I was in Florida. They asked me if I was stationed out, located in California, because they would get a lot of actors from California to come to Orlando because they didn't felt like the people in Orlando was qualified for the stunts and all the stuff we were doing.
Okay.
And then after that, it was Sheena. No, not Sheena. It was Target commercial, beer commercial, Nigerian beer commercial. Mm-hmm. And then it was Sheena, Tigerland, Snow Dogs, a lot of old school stuff. You can tell that I've been in for a long time. I've been in for since 97, 98.
Yeah.
And then once I moved to Georgia, that's when other stuff started opening up for me. Yeah. You know, more like Black Panther, Burden, Sleepy Hollow, 24 Legacy. It was fun. It was awesome. It was great meeting great people as well.
Let's go to the Black Panther audition. I heard that they had millions of people. People were driving in from out of state and everywhere to just for the opportunity to audition. Tell us about that.
Well, it was great because it was a lot of people of color walking around looking amazing.
Yeah.
You know, they garb they were wearing, they were wearing their garb. They were very traditional, very traditional. And it was like I stepped out of one life and jumped into another life. It was amazing, you know. And what we had to do, we had to stand in front of the camera, do a certain couple things and stuff like that. And they said, okay, next. It's almost like we call it a cattle call. So we had to come in there, do what we had to do, and then come out. But then also they asked me to audition for a fight scene.
Mm-hmm.
Towards the end where Chadwick fought Michael B. Jordan towards the end.
Yeah.
When they all got together, they all fought.
Everybody was fighting.
I didn't get that part again, but I was still there. I was on top of the mountain, and I had my little cameo shot. it was good. It was amazing. It was like going to work, like going to a family reunion every day.
Okay.
It was nice.
Okay, so after that, you were in the film Burden with Forrest Whitaker again. and who else was in that film? Usher. That was a very good. Now, a lot of people haven't seen it. I believe you can still see it if you have Amazon. You can go to Amazon Videos and check it out. It's a great film. But tell us about that one.
Well, that one was, we were handpicked for that Pacific scene.
So your agent said they want you.
They said, we want him, and her. So yeah. They really picked us in the dirt when they set us up for that scene.
Yeah.
They came up, the PA said, and the director, he said, well, we picked you personally because you had that look, what we were looking for.
Yeah.
And same thing with Black Panther. Yeah. They picked us for that certain look. And so anyway, in Burden, they picked me and a couple other people for that look. At that time, it's supposed to take place in the 90s, 1990 something. And I guess I had that 90s look. I had to bandana on my head, and I had a gray shirt on, a white shirt. I forgot what gray or white. I forgot what color it was. And it was nice because I got to hang out with Usher for a while because I was in that scene where Usher was standing next to me on my left, and the other guy was standing next to me on my right. I was right in the middle, eating a piece of chicken. not stereotyping, nothing like that. But I was sitting there eating a piece of chicken, and it was nice. Usher was cool. The guys were cool on the set. I worked with the guys before on other movies. Like the one guy I worked with, he's in Black Panther with me. as well, and he's in Coming to America with me. Mm-hmm. And it was nice. It was nice. It was like a 3-day shoot.
Now, you had mentioned that you have been picked a lot for films because of your look. It's kind of weird that you said that. I was in a movie about high school kids. I actually went there to work in makeup, and they picked me to be one of the high school kids, and I was 27 years old. And it
must be nice.
And I was like, then I said, whatever, you know. I was almost 30 and they picked me.
That's a good thing. That's a good thing. You're still holding it down. You still look young.
It was so weird. And I was like, do I look that young? You know, and you know, when you're in your 20s, the last thing you want anybody to say to you is that you look like you're in high school. So I insulted, but then I said, oh, don't be mad. Don't be mad. Take this money and run. You know,
the experience of money and run.
Yeah. It's crazy. So did they think that you look, did they want people who look more ethnic or, you know, look like maybe they were from Africa, like straight off the boat?
Well, I don't know about straight off the boat, but wouldn't have no clothes on. I've been walking around with like,
I remember you telling me that, you know, people from other countries think that you're from their country. So do you?
Yeah, it definitely is. It's all of the above what you just said, you know, look ethnic, look the part, look at the look. Well, my background is strongly from that background, you know, I mean, Africa. My mother's African and my father's from Louisiana, and he had an ethnic look. When I think I showed you a picture of my father, he looked like Mandela, you know, and so I got a little mixture of both.
Yeah, you look more like you look more like your mom. You
do. Yeah, definitely. I hear that a lot. Thick eyebrows and the cheekbones and but when I was on set, it's funny because I was watching people watching me, you know, other actors and background and stuff like that, and I was just wondering. And when I stood up and when I put my garb on, what they had me on, what I had to wear, a couple African brothers came up to me and says, are you from Mandy? Are you a Mandy tribe? And I was like, I don't know. Do I look like I'm from Mandy? And he's like, yes, you look official. You look authentic. You know, and when I lived in Florida, a lot of them thought, you know, I looked the part. So I guess I am the part and didn't know it.
Yeah.
But now I know it now because I embrace it more. And it feel good that, you know, in other countries, you think people look different, but they look the same. It's the only thing that's separating is knowledge and wisdom and a destination.
All right. You
know? So it was good. I get that a lot. A lot of people think I'm from another country anyway, especially when I'm garbed up or I have a certain look on my face or if I'm clean shaven. Mm-hmm. Like
okay. Now let's fast forward to your recent film, which was Coming to America Part 2. Wow, which I've seen that. I've watched that maybe three, possibly four times. You know, I love the movie. It was great. How much fun was that, making that?
That was a lot of fun. Mm-hmm. You know, like I said, being on set as much as long as we were on there, we were on there for like a week. Mm-hmm. And it was fun because we got to mingle with the actors a little bit. We got to clown around, we got to be ourselves, but when it came to work, we had to be, you know, always be serious. It was fun because looking at Eddie Murphy, it's just like, wow. See him on TV all the time and hear him on the news.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, now I'm sitting right across from him.
Mm-hmm. Now, if somebody didn't know you, they wouldn't know you because you were very clean shaved, you know, in that movie. Did people recognize you in there?
Well,
was it just
if they recognize me? I don't know if they're looking at me because they think they see me before. But I do definitely, honestly, I do hear sometimes at work people say, "You do look familiar." When they find out I've been in movies, they say, "Wow, I knew you look familiar." So you look like the type to be in a movie. Or they always, the young guys at my job, they say I look like an action figure.
That's a big compliment. You look like an action figure. You look like Superman. Well,
I hear that all the time, you know, when I lived in Florida, you know, and it made me feel good that I definitely put in work that people noticed.
Yeah.
Especially something positive like that. And it's a good feeling. But there's some people who did come up to me and say, man, I seen you in, I know I've seen you before, mm-hmm. or you've been in this movie, I can't believe it, but let me check it out. And they say, yeah, I know I've seen you, you know, just like, and it made me feel good, you know what I mean? I'm not boosting my head up, it made me feel like, you know, all that or stuff like that, but it was a good feeling. It was, especially the movies I worked on, it was definitely movies that was inspirational, historical, and fun to be on, and it's historic, you know? So it was good. It was nice. But people do know sometimes.
In a film also about the Tuskegee Airmen.
That one I love the best because I got to meet the Tuskegee, some of them, Tuskegee Airmen. Mm-hmm. You would never really recognize me unless you know me.
Yeah.
Because I was clean shaven, bald head. Now my hair is braided. I got an afro when I pick it out. And I'm a lot older.
Yeah.
And that was beautiful to be on set for that. And I didn't realize how important that movie was.
Yes.
Until later on when I was on set and when they showed us the movie and then when they finished project, finished product. And it was nice. It was nice. I met, like I said, met a couple of the Tuskegee Airmen. And I was one of the principal pilots. I was one of the main pilots in there. And the director was like, he wanted us to do a certain scene on the set. But everybody else was kind of stiff. And I was like, wait a minute, why are everybody so stiff for a scene that he asked us to do, especially the situation we were supposed to be in? Like, I'm gonna give you a scenario where we were in a bar where the African-American pilots, they come to the bar after they fought the war and did everything they're doing and putting their life in danger. Now they can't go to a bar, they can't go to a restaurant, they can't go to eat. And all of a sudden I felt all that come into me. And I reacted, and everybody looked at me like, oh man, he's gonna get kicked off the set. Why do you act like that? And the director, that's good. That's what I want. That's what I want to see.
He wanted that emotion.
It's another, you know, when you say that, I'm gonna tell you about another story real quick is when I was, did Snow Dogs with Cuba Gooding Jr.
Yeah, that was
a scene where they had me way, I'm talking about, I can't give you how far I was, but it was distant from the camera. And every time they said cut, I moved up a little closer. So then they said cut, like after 16 or 20 takes, I'm right in front of the camera. And it was a scene where Cuba Gooding Jr. finds out that he was adopted and his father's white and his mother's black. And he's in a daze. He's walking across the street and then some marathon like bikers come bikes. On a 10 speed come riding by and he just keeps walking in a daze. Mm-hmm. And he don't look around or nothing like that. And the bikes stop in front of him. They all fall off the bike. And I bust out laughing because it was funny. And they were like, yeah, that was good. I like that. That was realistic. And everybody followed right behind me. They started laughing too. And that was supposed to be that in that scene. That was my big debut scene where the camera's right in my face. I'm laughing, all this stuff. And then a lot of people didn't show up again to refilm that scene again, so they had to cut it out.
Oh my goodness!
But it was cool though, man. Cuba Gooding Jr. was a nice guy. I took pictures with him, and he invited me to take a picture with him and stuff like that. It was nice. It was nice.
Wonderful.
Got to get into character, so I got into character. Took a chance, you know. With director, all he could say is, "We don't want that," or "You can dumb it down a little bit," or "Can you raise it up a little bit?" Mm-hmm. So that's the thing about being on TV. When you're on theater, it's a different story. I did that as well, too. So
fantastic. Well, we are just about out of time. I've had so much fun catching up.
I have to talk. Yes. You look very lovely, by the way.
Thank you. Thank you. Talking to actor, we didn't get to talk about the, you know, we'll talk again and we'll talk about some of the bodybuilding and
fitness training and stuff. Yes, that's my passion. That's my love right there is getting fit and helping other people reach their fitness goals as well.
Okay. Give everybody your social media handles so they want to contact you.
I got one on Instagram. It's called Fit for Life. Mm-hmm. And I got one called Crumb Fitness. And I got one called Fit to Be Fine 9, F-I-T, number 2, B-E, 9, F-I-N-E, 9. And my email address is lawrencecrumity2@gmail.com.
Amen. Thank you. All right. And of course, you can catch me on all social media outlets. Just go to my website at msninataylor.com. LC, I thank you so much for being on the show. Thank you.
All right, everybody. Thank you. And I appreciate you inviting me. I'm looking forward to next time.